This is a tough line for a Friday morning, but a vitally important one, and it's time for us to work out how to address it. On average, Canterbury police attended 11 call-outs per day last year, 11 a day for attempted suicides. According to the latest police figures, that's a 59% rise, so 60% in 3 years, which is a disaster. Canterbury was highest, but significant increases, terrible increases, were also reported in Northland, Waikato and the Central and Tasman districts. And that meant that nationwide, the number of such call-outs have jumped by 40% since 2015. Why? What's driving this, and are we doing enough on the front line to help people at risk? We're going to deal specifically with Canterbury, where the rate was so high, up 60%, and we are really grateful to be joined from Christchurch by youth health advocate Dame Sue Bagshaw. Dame Sue, I know you don't like being called Dame Sue, but I do want to congratulate you for your richly deserved Queen's Birthday honour, and we're really delighted to have you in the studio with us. Thanks for coming in, although I'm sorry we're talking about this. What the hell is going on in Canterbury?
Well, there's tons of things going on, and I think it's impossible to point to one thing. We know that a lot of things feed into people who attempt suicide or who self-harm, and there's many, many reasons. In Canterbury, more especially, perhaps, we also have added reasons in terms of repetitive trauma from outside, if you like, rather than from perhaps within one's own family sphere. And, you know, we didn't have one earthquake, we had 500. We didn't have, then we had Port Hill fires, and then we had floods, and then we had Kaikoura, and then we had the shootings. You know, and I think it's one on top of the other. And then there's all the stresses and strains of living in the modern world.
So you're right, the stresses and strains of living in the modern world alone are a precarious business for many people. But when you go back over what's happened in that city since 2010, it's not a statement, an overstatement to say people are just exhausted, aren't they? And when you are exhausted, your resilience and your ability to bounce back is seriously impaired. And I feel like we've had very many conversations about bricks and mortar rebuilding in Canterbury, but have we done enough to rebuild people's psychological, mental well-being?
No, I don't think we have. I mean, it was a pleasure to hear of the Hearanga report saying that we need more investment in mental ill health, but we also need more investment in creating mental health because, you know, we try and treat mental ill health, but only 3%, and as the report says, probably 20% that we need to be treating. But we forget that we also have to actually create some mental health. We actually have to give people a point to live, and that means employment, it means decreasing poverty, it means giving some people, well, especially young people, a point. So that means having things to do, learning things, creativity, you know, all those kind of things that we really need to actually maintain and create mental health so that we can have that, if you like, ability to fight against all the stuff that's happening around us.
Has there been enough of that? I think, terribly, this is the first time I've heard anyone say that we have to give people a point to live, and in Christchurch that has to be a very explicit and predetermined and willful action, doesn't it, by a whole lot of agencies. Central government, local government, everyone has to buy into that, right?
Yeah, I mean, I think we need to change our politics, because our politics in the last 30 years has been around me first, success. Success means getting lots of money, and that doesn't work for human beings. For me, mental health is created by good relationships and having that good, safe confidence that somebody respects you and you can respect them. And, you know, in Christchurch, what we're trying to do is say, OK, we've got problems, what's the answers? So what we're trying to do here is create a hub for young people so we can have a place where people can come create those relationships, whether it be a social worker or a friend or... But do that in a context where there's not just helping services, but places to have fun, places to create, places to actually expand your mind so that you can overcome the politics and the demands of the modern life and actually counteract spending most time on your device.
Yeah. It is worth remembering, and I know we started with this, but it is worth remembering, and you were talking about young people, what they've been through. So they've been through 500 earthquakes they would have felt. They've been through potentially mum and dad in the family home being red zoned. They've been through the stress and strain of EQC or insurance disputes. They've been through all the domestic disquiet that all of that stuff induces. They've been through schools being closed or half closed or shared. They've been through the loss of their CBD. So they desperately need somewhere to go, don't they? And they desperately need the feeling that they will be safe there.
Absolutely. And that there'll be the people there who care for them, respect them, and kind of see their potential. You know, they don't believe in themselves anymore, because what's the point? We've got to get that back into the point of life is actually great relationships with other people, and actually create spaces where that can happen, and that connection with other people can happen.
What's the most important thing that can happen? And let's sound a call for a meaningful response to this. What is the one thing that you would like to see that you genuinely believe would make a difference in that city?
I think the one thing is actually organisations, people doing things together, not competing for funding, actually doing things together for funding. Politicians doing things together. I know, you know, there has to be, you know, either side. But at the same time, when there's important stuff like this, people's lives are at risk. We need to be doing things together. And the hub is a place where we're actually attempting to do that.
Dame Sue Bagshaw, your determination and singular application to the mental health of the people that you live amongst has been a remarkable thing, and it continues to be so. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. We really appreciate that. We do want to say this is really important. If you or someone you know needs help, there is help available. Now, Dame Sue's talking about the hub, but we also are putting up some phone numbers now. I think the most important thing is that if you can't help yourself and you feel genuinely imperiled, find someone you trust and tell them you need them, and they will find these numbers for you. But don't do this alone. And there are people who care about you, and there are people who will help you, and it's been such a tough time in Christchurch, hasn't it? Boy, oh boy.
Sure has.